Get your TV to get the best of live and on demand. Introducing DirecTV Stream.
The only deal that comes, the only good quality and reliability now. And only Verizon's been most awarded for network quality 27 times in a row. That means the best experience with calls, texts, and data usage of any major carrier, according to customers. There's only one best network. The only one ranked number one in reliability 16 times in a row. We are looking 5G Verizon.
I wish more people knew how easy it was to get health coverage. I'm only paying $52 a month, but there are quality plans for even less.
My job has to offer health insurance, but with the new law, I'm going to form a plan and only pay $47 a month.
Actually, a friend of mine recommended healthcare.gov, and now we're paying less than $60 a month for coverage.
I was skeptical at first, but it is real. I'm covered with no monthly payment.
New law, lower prices, more people health at healthcare.gov.
Good morning, my beautiful people. Merry Christmas. Well, good morning. What's going on, OG? Give me get some coffee. We're going to sit down and talk about last night, y'all. I cannot believe what happened to me. Y'all going to cry a river with me, but I'm still here. I'll be right back.
Oh, God, Jesus. Let me take this thing off my head, y'all. I'm coming. Let me look presentable. Oh, God. Happy day after Christmas, y'all. How many of y'all hungover like me? When you really don't drink, but you have some eggnog and too much apple cider and somebody's Sprite punch? I mean, oh, God, really? That's what goes down with family, y'all. I'm putting some sugar in my coffee. I'm about to sit down, y'all. I'm going to talk about some things, and we're going to talk about Christmas 2021. I still have Christmas presents under the tree, and I need to open them. I really do, y'all, for my daughters and significant others that I just broke up with, and now I'm a single woman. Y'all going to love to hear about this card. A lot of y'all told me to let Cheese Myers go, but I did not know that he had another cheese on his side. My Christmas wasn't as good as it seemed to be, y'all, but I thank God I'm still here. I'm not complaining, but I had to cut up last night. I almost went to jail. Fighting over a man I thought was mine belonged to somebody else. I'm coming, y'all. Y'all gonna cry real with me, even though I don't cry it out. I'm about to sit down. First of all, I hope I'm talking to a millionaire out there. I don't know how many who played Powerball last night. It was up to $400 million, and I did not play it. And I'm about to sit down and say Merry Christmas day after to everyone. What's up, Stock? What, matter of fact, Stock and Sport, you've been here for a minute. Y'all got to excuse my puffy eyes because I'm just waking up. Oh, God, no earrings, and my hair is up still from last night, and I look like last Christmas. Which was yesterday. But OG says, good morning. Four Corners Custom Products. How you doing, darling? Good morning to you, my brother. Hey, OG, everybody out. Touch base, drop links. And Stock Explorer, I think you're supposed to be a mod. I don't know what happened here, but I'm going to give you back your blue so y'all could drop links because I would love to see some your content for Christmas or whatever you're doing. I love you, OG. I can't wait till you do put some more stuff out there. But the Stock Explorer, I was by your channel, I think, a couple days ago. You're doing pretty good, brother. And I love that. Hold up. I messed up, y'all. I didn't mean to delete you, baby. Please forgive me. What I'm trying to do is make you a moderator. And I didn't mean to delete your message. That's me. I need to have my glasses on. Please forgive me. That's why I need a better mod than me. Okay? But last night, y'all, let's talk about last night. I had a party here. Went to my dad's house, his people's house. Now keep in mind, my real father's gone, but my mother, she married another individual,
and they had a party. I called him stepdad, you know, because he'll never be my dad. But at the same time, I tried to make him feel like he's a part of the house, the family. We went up there, and my so-called boyfriend, Ronnie Myers, was dancing with this woman too closely. I didn't think anything about it, but my sister said, "Stacy, ain't cheese on that woman a little too much?" I said, "Well, so big, because, you know, I'm dancing with, you know, other people, you know, no problem. You know, that's what we do." And she says, "Stacy, I believe that cheese, your boyfriend, that's his ex-girlfriend." I didn't think about it, but something's a hold up. And I looked over there. He was getting all down, getting freaky with the girl, and I was like, so I didn't say too much because, you know, I'm still trying to act like a diva that I am. I came home. He had his car. He didn't come home last night. He's still out. So I called my sister, and I said, well, Keisha, I said, you think he with him? She's like, duh, what you think? I don't know. But if he is, he can get his shit and get the hell out of my house. Sorry, y'all, but I had to say that. I'm still a lady, but I cannot take infidelity in a relationship. I don't do it. I'm not going to take it from nobody else. So my Christmas is like, what really happened? I mean, really. I can't blame the man because I ain't seen the man. He's not home. Maybe he's just too drunk. He don't drink. So there ain't no reason why you shouldn't be here, right? If it looked like a bird, smelled like a bird, there's probably a bird. Do I think he's cheating on me? Possibly. If he is, am I going to cry? Maybe a little bit. What am I going to do? Kick his ass up. Excuse me, y'all. But anyway, Merry Christmas, y'all. Merry Christmas. I'm just waking up, y'all. I'm still a little hungover because, you know, I'm not really a true drinker. I had probably two natural lights and a little bit of eggnog with alcohol in it. Thank you, Four Corners, for dropping your links, baby. Thank you. Let's check him out, OG. Yes, you know, let's try. And OG, I can't wait till you come out with some more content, darling. Really? Baby, you are on it. I mean, I am waiting for your content. Merry Christmas to you. What did, let's see, how you do yesterday? What you do yesterday? Oh, gee, I came home last, I'm gonna say, I woke up. I did a couple live streams. You know, I'm already a little tipsy from the holidays, drinking eggnog with my daughters or whatever. And then we went to this major party last night. And all stuff just jumped out the bag. I mean, really. My so-called boyfriend, I think, is cheating on me. And that's just the way it is, you know. But I'm not going to cuss and show out in front of this live stream. Because I could be wrong, but I don't think I am. Because he's not here. And that's cool. Because, you know, if one man can't love me, then somebody else will. I never chase after anything God don't want me to have. That's how I like to put it. I mean, I need to come out of this road because it's hot. The weather here is nice. It is. And right now it's a 55, 56 degrees. It's supposed to be 70 degrees. I mean, yesterday, the woman was born. It was like the temperature was up to 55, but it felt like 35. But anyway, this morning I'm just getting up. And I wanted to see, you know, who was live streams from yesterday's Christmas. And I seen a couple of them. I mean, everybody, I had a lot of things going on yesterday from live streaming. And I didn't really live stream that much. I think I went to shop and I just played a little bit of Christmas music in the background. You know, so people get the feel of Christmas. We didn't get any snow, and I wish that we did, but you know, we didn't get any white snow. And tonight, I would say, I hope I win some money from the, Powerball. And I got two tickets I haven't checked yet, so I'm hoping that maybe I want some little bit of cheeseburger Christmas money, honey. That's all. And I look, oh my God, I still got makeup on. I look terribly horrible. And y'all see my hair? I put it up. Now the champagne. Oh Lord, oh my God, now it's a mess. No earrings, no nothing. This is what I look like in the morning. A hot mess, right? I look a hot mess, y'all. I'm sorry. Normally I would have got a little bit better than this. Good morning, everyone. Good morning, Deborah. How are you doing, honey? Deborah Cabasa, Home Living. You got content, darling? If you got content, you're welcome to drop your links. Let me make you blue so you can do that. We are a group of YouTube creators, and what we like to do is take care of one another by putting you on the map. You know what I'm saying? Merry Christmas to you all. Yeah, I think the alcohol coming out of me. Y'all got to excuse me. And then I'm going through a premenopause. So me drinking yesterday did not help anything whatsoever. And it's getting hot right now. I got the heater on. I need to turn it off. So please excuse sweating. I am not a drinker, guys. I drank two beers. I'm drunk more than Stone Cold Steve Austin. Last night I had three beers and danced the whole night away. But I'm a happy person, you know. I believe in spreading good cheer, and when I'm a little tipsy, you know, I like to rock it. I like to dance. You're welcome, honey. So what did y'all do for Christmas? What did y'all get your Christmas presents? Me, I got presents on the tree. I didn't open yet. I mean, really. I got a beautiful purse. I see, and I know I got a good old gold or a diamond watch under there, and I have not opened it yet because my daughters told me what they got me. And me, I like to make sure that they okay. They open their presents, and anything goes well or whatever. I love them, but, you know, I would always, always take my presents back to the store and give it to back to the person, the receipts, and make sure they got everything they need. You know, I love Christmas. God knows I do, but I believe in giving than receiving. I've always been like that, and that's just part of me. That's just part of me, y'all. And I'm feeling kind of, you know, still from yesterday's holiday, so please forgive me, y'all. Trying to get it together this morning. I think I'm going to have a hangover. And instead of me drinking, I should have been drinking water and doing my exercise and, you know, but it was Christmas, and I had a wonderful time. I did. I'm a hungover, though. Y'all got to pray for me. And that's only one time of a year I drink like that. And I think I had too many apple ciders or, I don't know, eggnog. But it was beautiful. 2021 is gone, y'all. It's about out of here. It is. And what a bad year it has been for me. But I'm looking for 2022. Woo! I'm claiming the name of Jesus, y'all. You got what you needed? Me too, honey. I woke up this morning. Thank God for that. You know, I thank God for that. Life itself is so beautiful. And I was talking to one of my cousins who spent over 20-some years in the Marine Corps yesterday. And he told me that he had C+E and PTSD. It made me sad, so I'm drinking coffee, you guys. Hope you guys, if you got your coffee, you got your light cigarettes, light them up, smoke them, you know. Get home in mi casa, your casa. But I was talking to my cousin yesterday, and I haven't seen him since I was like, I don't know, like 9 or 10 years old. And he spent 20 plus years in the Marine Corps. And he told me he was diagnosed having a schizophrenic, and he has PTSD. And I was like, what? Are you shitting me? That's what I said. Because how can somebody as hardcore as him have PTSD? Well, guys, in the military, you guys, you know, we go through a lot of things. We do. We risk our lives. We get loaded. We get blown the fuck up. Some of us die. Some of them make us back. But some of us here. And some of us have the battles of war. Now, thank God I don't, but he does. My cousin, he was Marine Corps, and he was, like, working with the Deltas. And, oh, my God, he is so... When you say grunt, he is the image of grunt. And hear him tell me that. It kind of hurt me. And Papa got little tears in my eyes. He said he went to the VA and they said he's schizophrenic and he has PTSD. And I said, what causes? He gladly told me. In the Vietnam War, he said that Charlie was coming and about 16 of them tried to blow up their brigade. His lieutenant colonel. Probably lieutenant colonel, I think we retired as. And he said that Charlie was coming, which is the enemy, and they blew up the whole brigade, which is over 150 people, his people. And he has been having it on his head for a long time, and lately he couldn't sleep. And the doctor told him that from those embarkments and being busted inside the head with another gun or whatever, it got a crack in his head, and it gave him C+E, something like Aaron Hernandez, and all the things he'd been through as a Marine, what he can't call hot flashes, why he got PTSD, was a post traumatic stress syndrome, which means you've been through something hard as hell in life and your mind just can't cope. So they put him on these things called not Ritalin, but antidepressants. And he said that sometimes when he take them, he feels suicidal. And I said, oh my God. Sorry, y'all. I'm so sorry because my heart goes out to him. Anytime a person risks their lives for us and comes back with the memories of war, I got to cry with him. You know, this is a soldier in me. I mean, this is my cousin, the one I look up to. The reason why I joined the military, I wasn't born in 1960s. No, I wasn't. I don't know. Vietnam was one of the hardest wars ever. Even my dad told me about it. And you know, as a service member of U.S. Army, but when in 1989 and up, I have to salute him no matter what. And it hurt me, y'all. It really did. Deborah, just drop her link, y'all. Deborah, we're going to check you out. I didn't want to bring anything. It's not negative to me, but it makes me aware that even people that got out the military still can have this. You ain't got to be in the military to get PTSD. You don't. You ain't got to be in the military to get C+D. You could be a wrestler or a football player or be a wife or somebody bang you side the head and all of a sudden, boom, you just snap on somebody. And this pandemic alone has caused so much, how can I say it, my English terms, when I speak Spanish, has caused so many people to, oh, this is a hard topic for me to talk about, have PTSD and, you know, health, mental health problems and stuff like that, because they stay cooped up in the house. They feel like no matter what, this pandemic is going to take them out. That's another source of PTSD. I wouldn't say it's more PTSD as being in the military or playing football, but still, mental behavior is something that we cannot close our eyes to. And I want to say a special prayer for anybody to feel like you can't go on. I'm going to tell you, the devil is a lie. Yes, you can. Yes, you can. My mother used to put it in her own persona. And mine is a terrible thing to waste, but when you don't, I ain't going to say what she said, because then I'll be talking about my dad and my mama. But I put it like this. If you need some help or you feel like you don't have a friend, you got me. I'll be your best friend until the end, baby. That's how I am. I'm always going to be that. And if you got anybody in your family that's going through depression, PTSD, I don't care. Call me. I will talk to them all day long. Let them know that God is good all the time. And you just hold on. You just hold on. Help is on the way. Because let me tell you something about the mind. See, the devil, the enemy, I like to call him Satan. I like to get up in there and tell you these things right here. You're not good enough. You're not worthy enough. The devil is a lie. Dab on him. Because yes, you are. You're beautiful people, y'all. You're beautiful people. And the reason why I get so emotional that way, just to hear people say that, because if you stop and look how beautiful life is, that voice that you hear in your ear that says you're not worthy will flee on its own. I know it takes a lot. I know it does. I don't have any mental deficiencies. I mean, I thank God for that after being in the military for so long or in life, period. You know, I just thank God for having a strong mind and a good heart. God said, if you put me first, he'll take you with him. I'm going to tell you, it's not over, y'all. It's not over. I love y'all so much. If y'all need a friend, I am right here. Talk to me about anything. I don't care how dumb, how stupid. You want to cuss? I cuss with you, baby. Don't let nobody take your joy because you are number one. And remember that. And Deborah is saying, I was a medic for, okay, Marines for 10 years. Hoorah! I come from a family of military and police officers. My son right now is a state police. Let me tell you something about me. I'm a command sergeant major, retired U.S. Army to work with Admiral Cola Powell, 32 years. I hear you, simplify. I hear you. And the reason why I can say that is because not only am I just U.S. Army, I'm all echelon because I work at National Defense University, at Marine Corps, Coast Guard, and all of the above below me. So, Miss Deborah, Merry Christmas, honey. Fellow assistant arms, you know, ain't just one court, it's all courts. You know what? One team, one fight. Cool. On you, baby. Thank Miss Deborah for her service and your family. And police officers, honey, let me tell you, I started out as an MP. I did. You know, the MP, if you don't arrest me, simply hoorah, simply whore. One core, one engine, one sound, well, military one. That's right. Hoorah. I love. Marines, I love Marines. I love you guys. Because you know one thing, Army, if you don't know it, for those who are not in the military, Army and Marines were like this. Navy and Air Force, but Army and the Marines were like this. We're like this. I love Marines. As she said, simply, hoorah, devil dog. In Army, we say hoorah. I don't know who come up with those concepts, but that's just the way it is before our time, I believe. But anyway, y'all, Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. Day after Christmas. You know, Jesus is the reason for the season every day. I don't just celebrate Jesus on this yesterday. To me, he's every day within my heart. That's right. That's right. Who in the world knows anything about danger more than us military people? I'm telling you something. When you got military on your side, you'll be all right. Ain't that right, Sister Deborah? We got you. We got you six and your nine. Your front and back, in other words. But Deborah, have you made any New Year's resolutions? Have y'all, any of y'all made any New Year's resolutions? I'm going to tell you, I made three of them. I said that I was going to start working out more, which I am. I was going to cut back on drinking, period, which I am. It's just Christmas. And the third thing I promised to do was get out and drive to military and see my people and CDL license. I got CDLs. I thought about driving. But I said to myself, I'm like, no, I ain't going to drive with no CDLs. Because the reason why I say that is because now truck drivers got the shortage going on. Now, Deborah, you know that. And Four Corners, you hear me too. They letting these young people, 18 years old, 19 years, get behind the wheel and driving long distance when we both know dang on well that is not safe for anybody. I was going to Charlotte yesterday, and I know you probably done heard a lot of this on the news, and some little young, 21-year-old driver couldn't stop the brakes, going down an embankment about, I guess it was about 50 degrees down to his slope. He couldn't stop, and guess what happened? He slid because the road was icy, and it caused a major catastrophic where 17 cars hit and two people died. And I said, what in the crap is going on? Now, I'm a master driver. That means I can train people and get them CDL license. First of all, you ain't got 5 years driving experience. I ain't giving you nothing. You're going to go back and get your permit, and you're going to drive at least a year or two. That's the standard. Now, we got these young people driving. I ain't saying everybody, but this one particular person, he was driving, he was drinking, and guess what? He killed two people. And I think there should be an age stipulation on that. I'm sorry, guys. I'm just old school. I think you got to be at least 25 to get CDL license. I mean, permanent CDL license driver all over the continental United States, because experience makes a good truck driver. It does. It does. You guys know that. Truck drivers have a dangerous job, too. I've drove for 15 years in all 46. Who? I know you have, honey. Was you a driver? Well, have you ever? I'm sure you said you drove before, so you know the climates and all that. And you know what? Four Corners, I feel you. I feel you. Roger to you, baby. But they got these young little baby boys, and I mean young people, 18 years old, driving, who barely know how to drive a car, not alone a big old truck. And I think it's a shame that, you know, even though we got a lot of shortages, and I love you truck drivers, I give y'all mad respect, because I love to, when I go like this, y'all just honk your horn at me. And I honk back. Y'all have a very dangerous job, and I think that we need to sit back, you know, and analyze people giving CDL license so soon. And be less, I like to put it like this, less traffic jams on the road. We have more experienced drivers, but I understand people don't want to go back. And my uncle got his own trucking company. He said, truck is not the same anymore, Stacey. I said, why, huh? He said, well, one thing, you go somewhere, you got to wait like you're in the military. I said, well, I can understand. I said, I'd rather wait patiently and then get on the road and drive intoxicated. So he said, I understand that. But trucking has changed so much. He said, now you got these new rules, these new stipulations. They let anybody drive, and that's just the way it is, you know? And I was like, oh, my God. And I stopped back with him. I said, well, you know, I said, you know, I understand that you've been driving for a long time. My uncle, he's been driving over 60-something years, honey. He just love it. But now he got his own trucking company, and now his whole thing is back. He like to get people jobs and try to make sure, you know, that he got 150 trucks in his trucking company. And he said one thing about it. He said, you got at least drove 10 years to, you know, get a job with him. And I can understand that. But he said trucking has changed so much, the weight stations and all these things. And now he was talking to me last night at the Christmas party. He said, you know, it's just basically like this. If you ain't old enough to drive, you shouldn't be trying to get behind no truck. At first, I thought he was talking about me. He was talking about my little cousin trying to get the CDL license. He's like 21, 22. He want to be a truck. My uncle told him, honey, when you get come 25, you come see me. That means he got to drive at least three more years, even though he's been driving all his life. But still, You ain't got no license. You ain't got no experience driving behind a truck for 5 years. He don't even talk to you. So, but he was telling me how much it changed, though. I mean, don't get me wrong. I love driving in a truck, 18-wheeler across the United States and all that. Because one thing about me, I love driving, and that's my outlet. And just getting in a truck and taking shipments to somebody who's been waiting for a long time to see us. I'm like, yes, it's finally here. Trucker, you're number one. And I'm going to tell you the reason why I love trucking is because I remember this Sylvester Stallone movie, Over the Top. That's one of them. I said, you know what? I could be a soldier or I could be a trucker. And I could be both of them I wanted to be, which I have because I started as a supply sergeant. Hi, Al. How you doing? Merry Christmas, babe. I started as a supply sergeant where I drove trucks and I went to become an MP, but ultimately I switched over to be Signal Corps officer that I am when I retired as. I had a couple MOSs along the way. I've been on Army 32 years. If you don't know what MOS is, that's the occupation that you do in the military. I mean, you're ain't about money because no matter what your job is, you're going to get paid that rank, but it's your specialized job that you do. I had a couple of them, and that's just the way it was. And I love driving. And my favorite place to drive is Alabama. Woo! Selma, baby. I love Alabama. All my best friends are in Alabama, Mississippi. I got friends in every state, but Alabama, that's the first thing to stand out. And I love Alabama so much. Oh, my God. Four Corners and what is it? You got Chumsey. You got Selma. If I keep going up, oh, my God. Wetumpka. I just love Alabama, y'all, period. I do. A lot of my relatives in Alabama. Selma. Oh, my God. Junction City. Oh, man. Mobile, Alabama. Yes, honey. I love me some Alabama, Mississippi. I just love all of that. Man. Y'all better say, okay, let me read the tale, y'all. Truck drivers have a dangerous job, too. I drove for 15 years in all 48 states. Who? I ride there Four Corners. That's what I'm talking about. Keep on trucking, baby. And then he says, PSA, don't forget to subscribe. Turn the notices, like, thumbs up, and comment, and share. It helps the channel algorithm. That's right. That's right. That's right. Facts, y'all. And y'all got any content? Al, if you got any content, then make it blue, baby, so you can drop those links. So what we do, what I like to do is just right here. You got channels, content, drop those links. But, baby, hey, Christmas is over. We still giving on these Carolina Diamond Productions. And that's what I do. I love to put you out there because I know people got 40K, 50K, 100K. Shoot, I like to put you out there. I really do. And I leave no YouTuber behind, none whatsoever. I don't care if you got two people. I'm there watching, you know? I could have been monetized on this channel a long time ago, but, you know, it ain't about that. To me, it's about meeting good people like you, you know what I'm saying? If I wanted to get potato soup, if I actually really, really wanted to get monetized and 1,000K, that's right, 1,000K. But that's, I think when you want 1,000K, that is the epitome of being on YouTube. I could have people in the military. Come on. Don't you join this channel. I command it, you know. Dang how I am, though. I do this out of love, out of respect and admiration for other content creators because I love getting on here. Even when I had a bad day like last night, when I think my boyfriend's cheating me, but I really don't know, it calms me down because the first thing I thought about is getting it in my car, go get me a beer or two, and see where the crap he's at. First of all, I'm not that dumb to get behind the wheel, drink or drive. They ain't going to get me nowhere. To be cheating on me, guess what? That's where he need to be, and I need to let him go and move on. See, one thing my mama said, don't believe half the things you hear. Don't believe half the things you see. That man might be taking care of his mom or something and forgot to call me. I don't know. What's up, Mad Max, y'all? What's going on? Mad Max, how you doing? Merry Christmas. Drop your links, baby, from your last gaming expedition. I've been waiting for you to go live 3 or 4 days, and I keep missing, I guess, because of the holidays. A lot of things are going on. But everybody, meet Mad Max. He is the man with the plan. He just hit 2.5, I believe. Is it 2.3? I thought I saw 2.5, but I know in the last chat, he told me he hit 2.3. Hands out. Throw him up for him. Mad Max, check him out, y'all. Y'all, drop your links. A couple people already have a Mad Max. Please drop your link so we can go see it, baby. Because Mad Max, let me tell you something about him. He's a YouTube guru. If I got any problems with gaming or anything like that, he's a man. I remember my first came up. And one of my first comment I ever got by any video was Mad Max. And he said, I've known her for a while, but I think she's gonna get it together. She's gonna be a great YouTuber one day. As long as I keep around people like y'all, I will be. My one thing about me, Mad Max, know I got heart. And about subscribe. Yeah, I love people subscribe. Don't get me wrong. I even hate when I lose one. But Mad Max know I'm more in about friendship than anything else. And he has been that definite friend. If I go through anything, even through my crazy emotions, when I get on here drunk like I used to, guys, because I don't do that anymore. Mad Max will be here, sit back. You don't say anything. But I feel stupid when I get off because I know not to get on here. A drunk woman ain't good for nobody, y'all. And you get on here, you think you're trying to be professional, people see right through you. I used to look at my old videos, and if I would just listen to Mad Max, do it when you're sober, go gaming or something. I wouldn't do, I mean, your conscience is just getting into your booty. And Mad Max, I love you so much, and thank you for being. I hope you had a Merry Christmas. All you guys, you know, to your families, hope you got what you deserve. I got things under my tree. And I had a, went live last night to do an unboxing, and I didn't because we left and went to a Christmas party and kind of wish I would have stayed and went live with y'all, but I didn't. And somebody's calling me right now. It's probably one of my daughters. So y'all, I'll be right back. Let me answer this phone call. I'll be right back. Lord, I didn't think nobody was going to call me. It's 9:15 on the East Coast, but it is Sunday. Oh, my God. I'm supposed to be going to church with my uncle today. Wow. Be right back, y'all.
Symptoms are keeping me from getting so I talked to my doctor and learned meta is the number one prescribed biologic for people.
Oh my God, y'all would not believe this.
The drink symptom of deep is 4 weeks. Then it's you and
yo, I love y'all so much. I'm gonna let y'all hear this. Well, I ain't gonna do it because I don't want to cuss y'all. It's the boyfriend. Yeah.
Hey, I need them to get them clothes. I'll take them back.
All right, there you go. He gonna call me and gonna tell me he need to get some clothes so he can take them back. I think I know what happened, y'all. He outside, and I locked him out last night because I didn't know. I guess, you know, I didn't add too many apple cider, a little bit of eggnog. You see him dancing with his ex-girlfriend. He had potential just to lock the door. And I looked outside, and I said, oh, my God, the man didn't cheat me outside. Okay, Mad Max, I'm here, darling. Hey, but Mad Max, before you go, I do have my Xbox up, and I'm ready to game today. Hey, the Carolina Panthers is playing today, are they? Is that bye week? And today is Sunday. Wow. I just realized, guys, today is a long, long weekend. It's Christmas weekend. Next week is going to be what? New Year's Eve. And guess what I'm drinking? Sparkling soda. Yeah, I don't want to drink anymore. I think the new thing is to stay non-alcoholic, you know? I feel better. Oh, man, I had to quit drinking now before last night. My tolerance is very low, guys. If I smell beer, I think I get drunk. And Lord knows I was one of the ones that loved beer so much. I used to drink 10, 15 back-to-back every day. But I had to because it was going to the midsection. You ladies is over the age of 40 and up. You know that when we do that and we're going through this thing called premenopause. Premenopause can start at 20 years out. You could be 20 years old and have hot flashes, depending on the pituitary gland and whatever your genetics you're going through. I realized that, you know, no matter how much sit-ups and push-ups I did, that I can't drink what I eat what I used to. And you late guys, you with a lady, and she starts sweating and just talking to her. It's called hot sweats, and she might be going through premenopause. Even if she's 12, 13 years old, well, some people have been documented go through it 13 years old and say the last and the 20 years after you lose your menstrual period, you can't have any more babies. Lord, we got to pray for one another. Eve, why did she bite the apple, woman? Why? But anyway, I can't drink as much as I used to. Tolerance is low. And that might be a good thing, y'all. What coin I gave 3 bananas. What 3 bananas? Yeah, okay, everyone. It's 9:15. I got to get ready for my mile run. Yeah, baby. I run every morning with my dogs. Ooh, come on, baby. Give me 5 of U.S. Army. Lift, 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 right, lift. Don't get me calling the cages this morning. I have a service dog, and I will be talking to you later, sister. God bless you. Have a good day. You too, Miss Deborah. Thank you so much for stopping by, my sister. And we have definitely got to talk, honey, because I love to run, too. And you want to run with a sergeant major? Honey, well, let's go do 10 with my service dogs. And I got a lot of them back here. I'm telling you, I got about 4 pups. And I hope you're having the best time ever. And run for me, honey, because I'm going to run later on, too. But right now, it's a little cool outside right now. And I like to run in shorts, so it's supposed to get 70 degrees today. So I'm going to run by the lake that we have down in South Carolina, because I'm in North Carolina, the state line. So I'm going to go down to South Carolina, run by the beach. And yeah, me and my dogs, we're going to do at least 5 today. I got to get all this cake and all this little apple cider out of me, and I'm going to drink tons and tons of water and work out, y'all. Yes, yes. My New Year's resolution is not going to start on the 1st. It starts now. Yes. Deborah, I'm going to run for all soul service members. And then you're going to have me crying today. Out of love, you do your thing. Hoorah, coming from a whoa. You run on, sister. Run on and see what the end is going to be. I promise you're going to do great, marvelous things. I feel you, my sister. I guarantee you this. I bet you had the rank of E6 and above. I already see a non-commissioned officer, you Marine. Lance Corporal and above. You do your thing, honey. Right now, it might be an officer I'm smelling. Leader, no leaders. What you talking, doing your thing right now, I know you a seasoned leader. You do your thing, honey. Simplify, hoorah. But anyway, y'all, and that's why I like being around positive people like y'all, because when I can't do, I know I can. Like yesterday, I didn't even want to go running. I didn't run yesterday, and right now I realize that I'm trying to drop these 10 pounds for my health, because my doctor VA put me on cholesterol pills, y'all. And it made me so, I didn't understand it. Saying my cholesterol level was too high. And hell, I don't even eat meat. But I realized it wasn't about the meat, it was about the alcohol, you know. And when I got out, retired from the military a couple of years ago, and I just started drinking every day. Where it got to the point where I was fighting my neighbors, losing my friends. I said, Lord, this is not how you made me. And I looked at one of my videos. I think it was Abandoned Boys that told me, taught me how to go out and explore. I was like, I got this. I get on here cussing people out and stuff like that. People like to see stuff like that. But then I looked at myself and I said, that is not the type of content I want my grandkids to see. I took that bottle on one of my lives. You can go back, probably tell you which one. And I turned up the alcohol. I said, Lord, this is not me. It was last year right this time, y'all. I gave up drinking for 9 whole months. Best time in my life. And then I became friends with Miss fucking wonderful Katie Roby. And Katie Roby, you guys don't understand, she's not, her channel's not gone. She's going on the 8th day of sobriety. She can do it. I talk to her every day. Look at you guys. I know everybody don't like Katie or Truth Patricia, those women. But Katie is not like Truth Patricia. Katie was a woman like I was. Drinking. Boom. One day, you realize you drank too much and you realize this is not what you need to do, especially when you get that first DWI. She's doing great, y'all. She's doing wonderful. She'll be back when she needs to. Right now, she's on her 9th day of sobriety, and she looks amazing. Amazing, guys. I am so proud of Katie. Because the reason why I love Katie so much is because her dad is military. She's a military woman. She just went through a lot of shit in her life, y'all. And just like we all, but alcohol is not the solution. We know that. Alcohol is going to do but one or two things. Get you drunk, dead, you're going to hurt somebody else, or you're going to be in jail. And when you realize that you're bigger than a bottle, great and wonderful things are going to happen, y'all. I can tell you, honey, I wouldn't say I was the worst drunk ever, but I was not too nice to my people, to my family, to my friends, you know. I felt like the bottle was my best friend, and I know the devil is a lie. And a drunk woman don't look good for nobody, honey. No, we don't. We women, we drink too much alcohol. We know what happened. We're going to start talking shit, start throwing things, and start cussing people out. It's okay to drink socially, but when you start getting drunk and it's a habit and you start cussing people out you love for no freaking reason because you're drunk, you got a problem, people. Put it down. It's okay to drink socially, but don't get drunk every day. One thing, it don't make you look good. Two, it makes you old. Three, it messes your body up. And who in the hell want to die with cirrhosis of the liver? Come on, y'all. Like my daddy used to tell my mama, No woman looks drunk for nobody. Well, who wants a drunk old B.I.T.? Mm-hmm. So I say that. I really do. But guys, I love y'all so much. I'm glad y'all are here. I really don't have anything to really talk about except the fact that thank God that Christmas, I love Christmas, but Christmas is gone. I can sit back and look at my presents and get ready for New Year's. You know, I love all holidays, but Christmas is my favorite time of the year. When you get back, sit back and you got a day off and you can sit back and listen to people that you love and we start making New Year's resolutions. Some of us make resolutions knowing damn well we ain't going to keep them. So I say this, live your best life every day because life is so short, guys. We have got to learn to love one another and thank God for what we have. And I thank God for small things, you know, that he woke me up this morning. Thank God for a great mind and good health. Thank God for you people I could talk to, you know. And if you had and anybody ever told you Merry Christmas from me to you. Mad Max has dropped his links and drop a gift off at your house, Mad Max. All right, Four Corners, that's what's up. Be right back, Mad Max say. And Al says, Four Corner, I gave three bananas. Then I see some little icons, present, thumbs up. Thank you, Deborah. Thank you. Thanks, Four Corners, Al says. And T-shirt and a gift. You're absolutely welcome, Al. Mad Max, I sub. All right, yeah. Yo, y'all, please sub. Get to know each other. Let me warm my coffee up, y'all. And we're going to talk about tonight's drawing. Powerball. Well, last night's Powerball was held on last night, guys. I haven't checked yet, so I bought two tickets. I don't know if anybody won the Powerball, which was $400 million. Hoping somebody woke up with some Christmas cheeseburger money, honey. I haven't checked my ticket yet. I bought another ticket right here. And I was trying to wait with Scratch and Pete to come on. I was gonna go live with him and scratch my own, but it's cool. Thank you guys for five thumbs up. I definitely appreciate it. I definitely appreciate it. Today what I'm planning on doing, guys, is basically cleaning up. I might leave the Christmas tree up until the first, or my grandpa used to say leave it up to the 6th of January, which is old Christmas. You know, guys, enough old Christmas is what some of the southern colored folks, I ain't gonna say colored, southern black folks used to do down the south. And you know, in the Jim Crow days, they take old Christmas trees and keep it up to the 6th of January. 6th of January, then everybody had that day off because they call it sharecropping and all that other stuff. Hold on, y'all. Who is it? Hold on, y'all. I'm live. Come on here. Yeah, but old Christmas used to be January 6th, and that used to be, you know, times that we would celebrate and give harvest. Thank God for the first harvest and all the other stuff down here in the dirty south. And it's been a tradition, and we always keep the Christmas tree up the 6th or the 7th of January. So, me, I don't think I'm going to keep it up that long, but I will keep it up to after the holidays and New Year's. And thank God for what it is. And a lot of my people in my family are taking out trees. Now, I went to my aunt, my Uncle Ed house, which is my dad's brother. They started taking their Christmas tree down last night after my Aunt Leah has to cut me two pieces of cake. She's like, girl, I'm getting tired of these kids. I'm getting tired of looking at all these bills I got to pay and all these grand. This tree coming down. She said, you want anything? I said, nope. She baked me a big old plate and I came home. And that was that. But y'all, football game is coming on today. I was going to go to church with my uncle today, but I couldn't make it. I'm not going to go. Not because I don't want to go, because the coronavirus and, you know, he was like, we got to sit outside. And I was like, well, we got to sit outside. I might as well stay home and watch T.D. Jakes, you know. But my uncle know I love him. He's a preacher as well. And he's debating about opening the church this morning. And I said, well, you know, I got a couple things I got to do, catch up with some homework and all the other stuff. And I got to do that and call my daughter, make sure they're all right. But hey, the Panthers play today, y'all. And how many got that cheeseburger money, honey? I mean, really? I don't even know what the numbers were for last night. And I'm going to get up and I got to take my shower or whatever and go out and see. And I'm going to also do some things outside. But I want to see who won. I don't know if anybody won the money or not. If you got your Powerball ticket, you might want to check it, though, because I think a couple people won the small prizes of $100,000. And I think there might be a millionaire out there somewhere in Chicago, they told me. But I don't think anybody hit the Powerball. If they did, and I haven't heard about it yet. I'm just really waking up anyway. But anyway, whoever got that cheeseburger money, honey, Merry Christmas. Going to have a good Christmas on them. They know they're a millionaire on Christmas Day. Whoa. I'd be like, damn, I'm Donald Trump money. You know? But anyway, seriously, and all bull crap aside, y'all. I've been on now about 45 minutes. Y'all. I'm going to say what y'all a few bit more minutes because what I want to do is look presentable for today, not old Christmas from yesterday. And I probably come on, we're going to cook some up. I'm going to cook some pinto beans and just sit back and share Sunday with y'all. We're going to call it NFL Sunday. I got a couple of those out there. I don't know if I want a game. I'm going to do something that's going to be fun. What it is, I wish you guys can give me some suggestions, no problem. But trivia night, nah. I don't know. Sunday, we're going to do something. That's why I like to say a variety channel. Sir? Yeah.
What?
Soda.
All right,
I pay you. And my Uncle Fred said, what was you at last night?
What was you at?
Probably red, because I slept on the wrong way.
All right, I'll be back.
See, guys. It's about what's wrong with my makeup. I went to bed with makeup on last night, and they still swole because I just woke up. He been outside sleeping all night, y'all. Oh, my God. Am I not a bad girlfriend or what? And my sister said she think he was getting too close to that girl. I said, whatever, because I was dropping like a side earning. I'm sorry, y'all. We've been together off and on, about 10, 11 years. He's a retired colonel from the Army. 62 years old. He might not look it, but you know, when you work out and you take care of your body, you don't even drink. He smoked marijuana. He's a stoner. He is. And honey, all he do is work, smoke, lay on that chair, put a hole in it. Ain't no hole in it, I'm just saying, because you know, we got dogs. We keep a protective covering over our chairs because they come in, they just everywhere. And they, you know, they we keep them groomed, but still. I got my dog, Katie. She sheds like crap. And we keep stuff up. They love playing. That y'all seen my little videos. And now they're big now. And now Katie got to get her neutered. But they like to jump on the chairs. Yeah, I'm hungry. I'm thinking about going to cook me some pancakes. But I'm hungry. Y'all want some breakfast? Y'all want to see me cook breakfast? Ronnie, you want something to eat? You ain't been walking yet. You ain't been worked out yet. It's 9:30. You ain't been walking. Norman, you work at, wait a minute, why did you go walking already? Well, do what you need to do. Well, yeah, I'm about to go in and cook me something, y'all. I'm going to take y'all with me. I'm going to cook some pancakes. Oh, yeah. So I guess we're going to spend a little bit more time together, y'all. Really. It's time to eat, y'all. And y'all see my kitchen. I already got... I'm going to cook. I'm hungry.
Everybody know I love to cook. I do. I'm going to make a couple pancakes. And I'm eating some yogurt. Don't have... Oh, I need some eggs. I don't have any eggs either. Lord, I need to go shopping. But one thing I love about Christmas is you cook, but after that, you got to go to the grocery store and do your grocery list all over again. So until I get dressed, it's going to be some pancake city.
I got some already pre-mixed from last night. So I'm just going to make about 2 or 3 pancakes, y'all.
I thought about some grits, but no, pancakes is all I need this morning. Just something white. So
I already put my little mix in there. I'm going to put a little bit of water, a little bit of milk. Yeah, but it's beautiful outside. It really is. Y'all can see what I'm doing. I'm about to mix my pancakes up. Y'all didn't know I was going to cook on this live stream this morning, but when you're ready to eat, you're ready to eat. And my grandkids are gone, and my daughters are now going back home. And I could eat some leftovers, but for breakfast, I just love me some pancakes. So I'm going to make about 2 pancakes, maybe 3, with this mix going. And guys, guys and gals, or men and gentlemen, women, the one thing I'm going to tell you about cooking is this. You ain't got one of these, you better go to Walmart and get you one. If I can find it. Oh, here we go. Skillet, baby. You want to talk about some good cookie? You better get one of these Alabama, y'all feel me? Get one of those, honey. And right now, I'm putting it on a 6 right now. I'm going to put me some olive oil. I love cooking healthy, y'all. A little bit of olive oil. I'm about to let it get warmed up. Now I got time to talk, y'all. I'm going to let it warm up because, you know, it takes iron skillet a little bit to warm up. But when it does, honey, it's like cooking Sicily style. But anyway, y'all, while it's warming up, I can keep talking. Good day, host, Moz, and chat. What's up? This backyard, what's going on, baby? Merry Christmas to you. Y'all, while that's warm up, y'all done seen me cook pancakes and eggs before. Let me show you the Christmas presents that I need to unwrap. Y'all got to excuse the system. The first thing I got from my grandson, and he knows I am an advocate for Carolina Panthers. I love Carolina Panthers. When I say that, I'm thinking about wrestling, but in my perspective, he got me this. It's a gamma, and he gave it to me. Woo! Am I not bona fide? But see, the thing about it, when my daughter made it, they sold it, made it too big for my face. So it's a little too big, so I got to go and do the adjustments. But yeah, there's one thing I got from my grandson, from Josiah Little himself. It's a Carolina Panthers mask, and my daughter made it. She made a lot of them, but she said, Mom, I didn't know your ears were so small, you know, and they are. I got a little head. That's one thing. Let me show you some other stuff. I'm going to put my pancakes in this grease so I can get cooking. Let's see what I got. Oh, you know, I'm the type of person, I love presents. God knows I do. And I got a lot of cards from a lot of my subscribers, but, and I got a couple of them from my friend. Miss Katie, it's fucking wonderful. I love her so much. And one thing I got, guys, is this pocketbook. It is called a Louis Vuitton. I think I'm gonna be rocking it in church. My daughter got this for me. I think she said it cost about $400 or $500. I don't know. But it's so cute, you know, a bag to match matching boots that I wore last night at the party. I just didn't take the pocketbook because I didn't feel like unboxing and unwrapping everything. As you can see, it is a nice, beautiful Louis Vuitton purse. And then another thing I got, I don't know what's in here, y'all. I have no idea. Maybe you guys can help me. Smells good. I'm going to put these pancakes on in a minute, y'all. It's, what is it? Best wishes. Merry Christmas, Grandma. My granddaughter must have sent it to me. I don't know what it is. And y'all see what I got right now? Let's see. What is this? You guys can help me because I have no idea. And it's from today year. I don't know. Some little, I don't know what it is, but it smells good. What in the world is this, y'all? What is it? And it smells good. And it says best wishes. It smells like in little balls, it smells like bath soap or something. I don't know what it is. And the card says, Best wishes, Anonymous, for you being a super YouTuber. I will not tell you my name, but know that I am sending you this because I know that you love Bath and Body Works. And there's no name on it, guys. There's no name. And whoever sent me this, I love you guys so much. And I don't know what it is because it came not with that, just that. It came with these things right here. I don't know what they are, guys. But there's these little balls. They smell so good. And it came with, I don't know what the crap it is. I got to look this up. Look at that. A Sudeir? What is that? And it came with this right here. What is that? Am I supposed to put that in there or something? I don't know. Not a day over. Fabulous. Some person sent me this. I don't know. And I thought it was so awesome. Thank you. I don't know exactly what it is. So if you send it to me, can you send me an email and let me know exactly who it is and who sent it to me? And I would definitely thank you. Thank you. Thank you for it. Don't know really what it is. I don't know, guys. It smells good. Am I supposed to put that in here or something? Put it by my bath? I don't know. It smells like some beautiful fragrance. I don't know. But anyway, I'm going to put that back in the box because I don't know where it come from. But whoever sent me this, thank you so much. Thank you so much. That was one of my beautiful friends who's a subscriber for me. And then I got another thing for my daughter, Chakia. Love her so much. I got another purse, y'all. No, actually, this is for my grandson, Ashley, and Josiah, and Ava, my grandkids. Yes. Y'all looking at my hair. It's coming loose in the back. I had did some twisties in the front. Y'all just threw it up because I knew we were going to be dancing, and I love country lines dancing. And, honey, we went to Marshfield last night, North Carolina, but y'all know Randy Travis, and I just danced the night away. Yes, I did. Honey, yes, had a good time. And I got something else here in the box, pocketbook. I got another pair of boots, stiletto boots for my daughter. She got me a hat, and I wore the hat, y'all. That's what I put my hat on. It was a cowboy hat. Put it on my head and went country dance, line dance, and I was like dropping and twerking and doing my own little dance, you know what I'm saying? And I had the best time. And there was a guy who told me how to do the two-scoop booty. Honey, he was, oh my God. It would take a lot of footwork for that. And I'm saying, yeah, I'll be right back and put the pancakes on.
Goodness.
But yeah, I'm back. One more thing, I'm warming my coffee and I'm gonna finish unboxing and stuff, and then I'll let these pancakes cook and I'll get out y'all with, because I know you guys got a busy day cleaning up after Christmas decorations and people leaving, and y'all here with me. Thank you so much, and happy Sunday. Happy Sunday, y'all. Okay, I'm back, guys. I'm gonna put my pancakes on. They're cooking. Let me turn it down a little bit so I can watch and chat at the same time. Oh. Yeah, I got a hangover from hell. Oh my God. Hell, I know two beers and eggnog can give you a headache. That's why you gotta watch what you're drinking. Who's drinking it? You drinking it with? But anyway, good day and from the backyard, and everything is good, honey. Merry Christmas to you. Oh, I got some other stuff I need to unbox, honey. Oh, Lord. One more present. I got one more present on the tree I have not looked at. And some Amazon.
From who? I don't know.
And I got lots of cards, guys. I guess maybe I'll do another YouTube occasion when I read all these cards I got. Lord have mercy. I must got over 150 cards. But I like to give shout outs to all of you guys who sent me something. I appreciate it. And, of course, I'll be returning a card to you guys. And some of you guys I already sent cards to. It's just a matter of time when they get there. You know, if you've been around me a long time, and you know, some people I didn't get, like Mad Max and you guys now, because, you know, you don't want to dox each other, ask anybody for anything. But I love to send you guys something for next Christmas. So I think about getting another post office box and not putting my house address on it, because, you know, you got to be aware of your surroundings. But so far, thank God, I have not had the opportunity to run into someone who's psycho, who want to blow me up with some crazy shit, you know, because they got my house address. I'm not that big yet. I'm not that famous. So, but somebody sent me one of these right here, and it's called Annie Klein. I don't know who. I'm almost certain I know. I want to say between Miss Wonderful, Corey Bradford. I don't know who sent it, but I thought it was so sweet. Hey, Matt Max, I'm unboxing some gifts I got from some of my friends on YouTube. And I got that from somebody, and I want to say thank you. Everybody tears in my eyes, because I didn't know, I mean, that much. Some of you guys that love me, I feel like I'm y'all babies. Mad Max, you know what I'm talking about. But someone sent me that, and I don't have a name that sent me that. It was anonymous. And whoever did, thank you so much. Look at that. That's nice. And it's real. I don't know, Hunted Gamer, and no, I don't think Hunted Gamer. I don't know who done it, but thank you so much. Thank you. It makes me tears in my eyes. Yeah, awesome people. I love you. And there's no card. It just says, from one of your subscribers, much love, Merry Christmas. Wow. Man, that makes me smile. Oh, my God. Y'all love me. You do love me. And I love you. Much love. Hey, and next Christmas, Mad Max, Deborah, Al, I'm going to send y'all something. Please. Yeah, I'm going to send something. And y'all had eyelashes on. I swear. Much love to you, baby. You got me crying. Thank you so much. But y'all know what's so funny? I tried to do fake eyelashes last night when I went to the party. And I did it myself, looking at tutorials from Miss Fucking Wonderful to True Patricia putting their shit on. Excuse me, y'all. I don't mean to cuss. Forgive me for cussing. Forgive me. But anyway, I tried to put them on, and I had them on just fine. And I opened my eyes, and I couldn't open them. Oh, my God. It took the world to get those things off my eyelashes, and I think I may pull some of my eyelashes off. Uh-uh. I thank God what I have. I can't do fake eyelashes. Never have. Never tried. I tried it last night. It's a done deal. No more of that. I like being naturally pretty. You know what I'm saying? If God didn't give it to me, I don't need it. Lord, and the glue is still stuck, y'all. I mean, look, my finger can literally get stuck right there, you know? Oh, man. I know beauty comes for all shades, all colors. If you love doing what you're doing, do it. But that eyelash thing, I just can't do it. I got to be natural, honey. I got to be Stacy Little, period. And eyelashes, mm-mm. If God didn't give them to me, I don't need them. So I took them out last night, threw them in the doggone trash can. I don't want anything to cause me to be blind. I can't drive going down the road. And I still, it get stuck right now. It's just me, not nobody else but me. I just don't know how to put eyelashes on. And I'm like this, if it takes that much to look cute, I don't need it, people. I don't need it. Hold on, guys. Let me flip these pancakes. I'm back. And one thing, y'all probably going to love for me to do, I know I love myself, is just I'm going to quit smoking cigarettes, really. I had quit before, but when my daughter and my grandson got COVID-19 and I got some of it, yeah, I had COVID-19. And it leaves a bad effect on your lungs, but I can do all things Christ Jesus strengthened me. I'm bigger than this cigarette. I am. And it's gonna be the last pack. The reason why I ain't putting $900, it's almost $9 down here for cigarettes. And but yesterday, as long as I stay busy, I didn't crave a cigarette until one or two things happened. When I started drinking alcohol, which I cut so much back on, I wanted cigarettes then in my first meal of the day and when I drank coffee. But as long as I stay busy, I didn't care about no cigarette. I didn't. I really didn't. And I know cigarette smoking is bad for your health, especially menthols anyway, y'all. But everything is good. God has blessed me with life itself. I don't have COVID-19. My daughters don't have it. My grandson, hallelujah, praise his holy name. He doesn't have it. He's clear of that. Even Corey is doing great. Thank God. Thank God. When I say Corey, I mean the Abandoned Boys, because, you know, he did have COVID-19, but now he's up playing games, talking shit, and got his clown mail on, and he's doing good. Salute to my brother from another mother. Yeah. But, man, Max, what's going on with TJ Smith? I have not seen him in a long time, and I did not know that TJ stayed right down the road from me in Bentonville, South Carolina. Good God Almighty. I don't know. What was that chick named? Cosmic Witch. Well, I don't know her name. They were saying something about TJ is not welcome here. And then Corey, Abandoned Boys, I don't know. But I'm just saying, I haven't seen him and Corey's live in a long time. Hell, Corey ain't been live like that in a long time. He's been gaming. So I don't know the story behind that. But TJ Smith, I love him, man. He's my buddy. Always will be. Don't know what happened. But I realize he don't go YouTube no more like he used to, Mad Max. I just would like to know where he is. That's my buddy, man. I mean, we down like four flat tires. You know what I'm saying? Mad Max, you know what I'm talking about. Man. And what else happened to my other boy? Oh, my God. Oh, I'm Coke 49ers. I love him, too. I've been seeing him. Since Corey ain't been live anymore, now he's gaming. I don't see everybody like I used to. Mad Max, I know they pop all at your channel. So I'm going to start coming to your channel more often, honey. I mean, let me turn this up. Skillet. Down. I've been trying to wait for you to go live. Now I got this big old break from school. But anyway, y'all. It's a beautiful Sunday. What time, Mad Max? Every time you say, I'm going to be streaming, I'll be waiting for you, wait for it, and I will never see you. And then when I go there, you already know I've been live streaming, and I'm looking at a GTA from last week. And I leave comments, but I would love to see you live, honey. I can never get you live. It's like you, Denny, and I love you. I need a time when you go live. You know, YouTube notifications sucks. They really do. And I miss you. You know I love you, Mad Max. And Trucker Z, AAP, hashtag 420. All my people. They'll be going live streaming. I don't see them anymore. I wonder if YouTube took their channel down. I've been stressed out too, man, Max. I'm having anxiety attacks and I don't know fucking why. I talked to my doctor. It's Stacy, it's because you're losing estrogen. That's all that is. I don't like it. I hate it. Stress, don't let stress get to you, brother. Go work it out. Go get a bunch of bag. You know what I'm saying? But my problem is not that easy. Either I got to go take hormone replacements for estrogen because my period is about, I'm sorry, wrong word. I got children in the room. Because I'm about to go through premenopause. I'm getting to the point, I'm getting older. I'm 45. Oh my God. I'm getting old. I got gray hairs might be coming in there somewhere. I'm looking. Knock on wood. Thank you, God. But even I do, I thank God for every point of it. Let's not get stressed. Why are you getting stressed out? But ain't nothing in this world you get stressed out about. Make it wait. Take care of you, man, Max, because I need you to stay around with me forever. We're going to grow old till we 1,255 years old. Okay, you get stressed out? No, not you, Mad Max. You the man with the master plan. We can have you stressed out, brother. I need you on my side, and you ain't going through no menopause. You didn't bite no apple, so you ain't got shit to be stressed out about. Imagine You wake up one morning and you just voluptuous, beautiful person, and all of a sudden, the things you used to think about, you don't think about no more. This is the life of a woman. I'm gonna give you reality. I used to love cuddling up. I used to love spending time with the significant other in my life. But lately, I want him to touch me. Women out there, it's over 35. Hear me the words, you're probably gonna laugh at me. Men on pause. Men on pause. Men on pause. See, y'all men don't have no problems like that. Drama shit that I get to hear. Oh, baby, I'm sorry about that, honey. Dab on that drama. We don't need no drama. We got enough drama on. I feel you on that. Hell, I just gave you my number one drama debate already. Menopause. And y'all men don't want to talk about it. I'm going to tell you something. One day you're going to be with a woman, and she's going to start sweating like a motherfucker. Like, damn, what's she sweating for? She's just sitting there. Is she about to have a heart attack? No. 9 times out of 10, she's probably going to be having a hot flash, going through menopause. Really? Facts. I was driving down the road yesterday. It was 35 degrees outside. Beautiful, beautiful day. And I had to turn the heat off. And first thing, my boyfriend going to say, what the fuck wrong with you? This word's come out of his mouth, y'all. I'm sorry for cussing. What the freaking frack is wrong with you? I said, what the freaking frack wrong with you? It's hot in this mofo. He's like, you trying to kill me? I'm like, what? It's hot. He said, Stacey, what's wrong with you? You sweating. I said, boy, I'm on menopause. And he's 62 years old, got all these sisters older than me. Yeah, I froze his ass. I'm not going to sit there and go through whatever he want me to do when you in my car. And if I'm hot, I'm turning the damn air conditioner on. And I turn it on. About 30 minutes. Froze his butt. I took a long break from social media and gaming to get away from it. And now it's back when I get back. I feel you, honey. We all need to take a break. No, I took one of the longest breaks, and I think it probably ruined my YouTube career, but hell, I had to put me first. My dad passed away. I took 1 year off, and man, I was up in there. Everybody wanted to see me. I was aiming with the big dogs. I mean, 40K motherfuckers, honey. But it had got so bad where I had people doxing me, sending me parts of their genitalias, and, you know, people just trying to make drama, races, and all this other stuff. People didn't want to see me blow up. And people gonna tell me to help me grow my channel. I said, what the hell did you say? Words coming, I should stop cussing. This military coming at me, y'all. I said, what the heck did you say? You helped me raise my channel. I said, the devil is a lie. Yeah. And every time I go live stream, somebody gonna come in my channel. They're gonna moon me or put an N-I-G-G-E-R. Man, I said, that's all you got. You better cut me a little bit better than that. You don't realize, honey, I'm Italian and black, and I wish a motherfucker would, is what I say. But I try to keep the peace, honey. But you got some crazy individuals out there. And I be waiting on that shit. And I try not to snap on them. But sometimes you got to snap, Mad Max. You know it. You've been in some of my channels where people just come show their little asses. You had to go sit there and literally cuss them out when you're trying to be a diva. Hell no. Ain't nobody going to. Don't come to my house cussing me or none of my people out. Ain't nobody crazy around here. Who you calling a nigger? I say, shit. I'm not racist. But I tell you what, don't let me be today. People just ignorant out there, honey. I try to be a Southern Belle that I am, but honey, sometimes I gotta let the deeper stuff go and just get down to the nitty gritty, because I ain't just gonna sit and let nobody disrespect my house behind my corner. You know what I mean? I'll be right back, y'all. I'm gonna flip these pancakes. Ain't nobody gonna insult my doggone friends. Not on my YouTube channel. Oh my God, I put the eggs with the pancakes, and my pancakes are so fluffy and brown. Yeah, I'm just doing the other side now. But Mad Max, I'm back. It's back with the drama. Mad Max, you know what? When I come to your channel and you make me a moderator, I promise you won't have no doggone problems. But I got your 6 and your 9, baby. You want to ever go live? I got you. Now, that's why I love going to your channel, because you handle it with so much, you know, you just handle it with ease. That's why I need to get some YouTube ethics from you. Because I'll snap. Somebody come acting crazy in my chat, I'm shutting the whole damn channel down. What the hell? ain't in your house messing with you. Why you gonna come bother me and my people? I go for them. I mean, I hold you two grudge. Then I literally let it go years later. No, but you know, I'm like this. If you had somebody's chat or somebody come to somebody's live stream, have some comment. Give them some respect. And it's not like I come to your house and say some crazy stuff. Then why would you do that to somebody else? That's just mad crazy, man. I hate trolls. I hate them. I hate people with drama. You got drama, keep that shit in your own house. Don't bring it over here. That's how I feel about it. If you're going to bring drama over here, I'm going to let the drama unfold. I'm going to dab on that butt. You know what I mean? It's just crazy how people get ignorant. Yeah, we got so much stuff going on in the world. We got pandemics going on, people dying of nonsense, you know, because people, scientists think they know everything, but hell, they don't, especially with this pandemic. And we ain't got time to be hating on nobody, you know what I mean? But the world needs us love, and people are gonna got to the point, they forgot how to show love. How the good books of many are called, only few are chosen. I thank God I'm in the number, you too, man, Max. We got God, we ain't got time for nobody's bull stuff. I'm trying to cuss on this beautiful Sunday. When you said that, baby, you took me back to times and YouTube when I felt like just giving up. But I said, hell no, I ain't giving up. I'm going to give up on that ass. People that piss me off. So, and then, of course, when I was drinking alcohol, I would really get mad. And, you know, alcohol only do it intensifier. But don't ever let nobody stop you from being you, Mad Max. I don't give a damn who it is. You made me your moderator. I swear to God, I was slaying the rich like a motherfucker for us, honey. Hey, I'm going to keep it 100. You know, that's me being military. No, that's just me being me. You know, I'm the type of person, I'm the sweetest person in the world until you get on my bad side. Don't come out to me and I won't come out to you. But when you come out to me, I'm coming for that ass, baby. Then some. But anyway, no more cussing, y'all. It's Sunday. I don't want to be cussing around nobody's kids because I'm a grandmom now. And I got to represent, darling. But I'm still that damn diva. Don't fuck with my friends, honey. No more cussing, though. Forgive me. And I'm a Cancer, July the 7th. Mad Max, you know my birthday. We Cancer, the sweetest people in the world. But when you piss us off, honey, you got hell on your hands. Don't miss my friends. Please don't. I got a headache, too, y'all. I need to go back here and get my morning started. Good Lord, honey, it's 10 o'clock. Oh, man, eat breakfast and all that, y'all. But anyway, y'all, I've been on 1 hour and 17 minutes. Oh, long Mad Max. I've been on 1 hour and 17 minutes. And Mad Max, I don't know what time you're going live, but, baby, I'm going to be there. I'm thinking on you, Mad Max. It's probably going to be like 1, 2 o'clock. 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, don't know. I'm going to be there, y'all. I'm going to be there for Mad Max. That's my big brother, man. But somebody tell me I had to get rid of a hangover. Oh, God, I can feel it coming on. Oh, my goodness. Lord, my head is hurting so bad. Jesus. Too much nutmeg. Oh, my God. Too much, what do you call that stuff I just said before? Eggnog. I think they had liquor in that shit, for real, yo. He going bang, 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 bang. What the hell, yo? I'm glad I didn't go to church today. I love God, don't get me wrong, but me going to church with a hangover is not good. My uncle see right through me. He's a preacher. You had too much last night, didn't you, Gab? Yes, sir. I'm here. No, that ain't the type of Christian I am. You give God your best, not your bullshit. Well, I guess I'd rather stay home. And I got homework to do, so. Yeah, but Mad Max, I'll be looking out for you to go live. And I need to put my house back in order after Christmas. Lord, you just see the good part of the house, and you ain't see the bad part of the house. The back rooms where everybody fucking sleep drunk. Still sleep. They still back there now. My brother, my cousin, they back there drunk from last night. And boy, they was drinking, throwing them back. Yeah. I mean, straight liquor. They the drinkers of the family. I'm cooking breakfast right now, so I got a lot of pancakes going on. So people get on the go, because I know that my brother is going to get about 12. He's going to head back to Oklahoma. Of course, you know, he's in the Navy. He's been in the Navy about 30 years and shit. And then my little cousin, he's also in the Marine Corps. He's been in the Marine Corps now about 16 years. They both are junior officers. My brother, he's a lieutenant colonel. My cousin in the Navy, he's like a 04 in the Navy. And then my daughter, she's in the back room over here. Of course, you know, she's Sergeant First Class U.S. Army. And she is doing her last year. She's not going to retire. She's only doing 10. So, and my oldest daughter, you know, she's got my grandson, my grandkids. She is right now in Norfolk, Virginia. She is an officer in the Navy. And this is going to be her last year because she's retired, but retiring. When I say retired, she put a paperwork in. They proved it. She got a date of 16 February. Right now, she's on permissive TDY. Permissive TDY is when you sit back and use all your leave dates when you actually retire. Your ACAB, meaning ACAB means where you basically sit back and you just, how can I put it in the terminology where you guys understand, civilianize it, is when you, they getting ready to put you back into the civilian sector and try to debrief you all the things you've been through in the Army, military, which will never happen because once a service member, you'll always be that. But, you know, they try to teach you not to talk shit when you get out, when you know you're the best. But they don't, you can't stop a soldier or a service member. You got it. And everybody wants us when we get out. Then you're going to give us this little small ass wage. Hell no, it's better off if you make your own business, I say. But when you retire from the government one time, two times, three times, you know, retire from the military, you can retire from another job and retire again three times from federal services. So the longer you stay in, the more lucrative it is for you. But don't stay in so long. When you get out, you feel like you're old ass maid getting back in the workflow. You know, once you out, go get that job. You don't want to work, and now don't work. You know, I mean, it's not the best benefits, but it's better than nothing, I say. Yeah, my retirement paycheck is $2,000 a month, baby. And I was a sergeant major. Not to mention what I get from VA, which literally ain't shit for me, sparing my life, busting up my knees, and hell, hanging out of damn trees and getting stuck and could have been dead 7 times 4, but thank God I'm here. Paycheck is not enough now, is it? Military, we don't get paid for what we're worth. We don't. We risk our lives where everybody home, sleep, goddamn, we go on missions and don't know we're ever coming back. But they feel like, you know, they're going to give us a little cheeseburger, a little change for our lives. Okay, so be it. Could be worse than that, but hell, thank God for something. You know, one thing about the government, they fast to take their money, but hard and slow when they want to give you yours, right? Are they supposed to be giving us some kind of a bonus or raise, y'all? But anyway, yeah, I've been on here 1 hour and 22 minutes. I'm talking to myself, and I feel like everybody has left me in this little thing, which I know is probably wrong. So I got 0 people in the building, 7 thumbs up. That is very nice. I love the number 7. You guys know I'm born July 7, 1977. That's me, Carolina Diamond, old girl called Stacey Lee Little. Guys, I'm tell you something about my ex-boyfriend to be. I'm finna ditch his ass, honey. I am. I know we've been together almost 10 years, guys, off and on. But when you a stoner and you got nothing else to do but stay stoned, and now you take you forever to come and see me, even though he's got his own fucking house. I need something better, man. I need like a preacher or somebody. You feel me? I just ain't feeling with this old cat anymore. Maybe I need to get somebody my age. Shoot. Ryan is a good friend, but as far as husband material, he's too much of a mama's boy for me. He asked me what's wrong with my eyes. Maybe because I see his ass. But much love, y'all. All I would say, thank God for this beautiful Sunday. Hope the Carolina Panthers win. We didn't win last Sunday. Hell, last Sunday, I didn't know they were playing. And y'all been sitting here talking. I ain't talking to nobody. Much love, guys. I'm about to go eat some breakfast. And I may come on later. I don't know. Because I'm trying to. Oh, my head hurting so bad from the ignore, y'all. But anyway, guys, it's been so real. I love you guys so much. And y'all have a beautiful Sunday. And Mad Max, I'll be there when you go live. If I get the notification, I'm figuring out you probably gonna go live like 1 or 2 when the football game is on. And that's cool because you know what I'm doing right now is like what I'm gonna be doing on the big screen watching that. Get my people on the road so they can get home. So let me do that because I don't think y'all want to see these people when they come out been drunk all night. Like, who the fuck is that? Sorry for cussing, y'all. I'm working on it. But until then, guys, much love. Merry Christmas. And thank you for the presents, y'all. Be blessed. Peace. Lord, I think I need to go to the store and get me a Tylenol. I got a headache, y'all. Too much eggnog. It's not good for anybody. Love you guys. Peace.